Subjective, objective assessment plan. I got a differential for this man.
CBC, DMP,
CT, UA.
When you are sick, just come see the PA.
Any past medical history you've had? Tell me about your grandma and granddad. Do you smoke? Do you drink? Do you take pills? Are you having any fever or chills?
Hypertension, I got it.
Diabetes, I got it.
Hashimoto's, I got it.
High lipids, I got it.
If you're ill, don't fret. I know we just met. I am your provider. I'll order a titer. Holman's, DT, McMurphy's, Abby, Murphy's, Coley.
Oh crap, her jelly.
He's sweaty and tired.
PKG, acquired.
Is his heart hopping?
If so, let's shock him.
As you can see, we are well-rounded folks. Treating complaints from depressions to strokes. Now you know all the things PAs can do. Don't you want us to take care of you?
So my favorite PA school memory is after we took a really hard ClinMed exam, we threw a surprise baby shower for LaToya. And as everyone's coming in for the baby shower surprise and LaToya comes in and she's really surprised, we all start crying. We're not quite sure if we're crying because we all think we failed the ClinMed exam or because we're just really happy for LaToya. But out of nowhere, Bryce says, "Who's cutting onions?"
It's for the new class. And it comes from the infamous Winston Bishop from New Girl when he tells Jess to just be there. On your first day of clinicals, you're going to be like a doe-eyed puppy dog. When your preceptor gets up, you're going to get up. When he goes into a room, you're going to go into a room. And inevitably, there will be the time where he gets up, doesn't tell you where he's going, and you end up following him to the bathroom. You'll share a short, awkward moment, but it'll be okay. What you'll realize when you're rotating is that your preceptor is not just your preceptor. The whole floor is precepting you. There will be so many people who will be willing to help you if you just make yourself available, make yourself approachable, and just be there. So learn as much as you can and be around and soak it all up.
I think the epitome of my PA school education was, did you get my study guide?
So there was this one time I thought I was going to have to identify the specific parts of these bones in 12 seconds or less, and I went into my professor's office and cried about it. But now I'm here and I lived through it.
Congratulations, class of 2019. We made it. Can't believe we actually got here. Shout out to Professor Miller for waking me up during that ClinMed final so that I could be here today. Congrats, grads!
So when you start PA school, your new classmates are going to become like your family. Unfortunately, sometimes your family can be a little annoying. But you learn how to deal with it.
From all of us to you, we just want to say thank you. Thank you to the moms, the dads, the brothers, the sisters, the boyfriends, the girlfriends, the grandparents, the husbands, the wives. We would not be here without you, so thank you.
Didn't think you'd graduate without hearing another one of my jokes. What do you call a cow that twitches? Beef jerky!
Hello, class of 2019. This is Dr. Robert Hill, your former program director, your professor, and always your friend. I am excited that all of you are about to graduate. You don't know what an accomplishment you've just attained is until you walk across the stage and you accept your long white coat. So congratulations to all of you and to your professors and to your current program director and to your dean and president of the campus, to all the people that help get you to this place, your family, your friends, but more importantly, each other. So we all salute you and say congratulations. Now you gave me a task of getting some questions together for your video. So let's see if I can answer them. It's the most memorable moment from our class. You know, the class of 2019 had so many great memorable moments. I think one that always sticks out to me was when you gave LaToya her baby shower. And the reason that stands out to me is because what I really saw from all of you is how you could pull together as a class and take care of each other and love each other and be there for each other. And, you know, I couldn't have hoped for anything more than for all of those things. I hope that you all never forget this time that you've shared with each other. I hope you never forget the time that you spent together in this classrooms, in this program, and outside of the classroom. I hope you always remember each other.
Oh, great. What's one thing that you learned from us as a class?
I learned that every student learns differently and that you can't just have a formula to try to teach material, that you have to make sure that you tailor items to certain students just because they're different ways and modalities that students find gaining material most helpful.
Ooh, the most memorable moment I think was the very first day of orientation where everybody sat in the room and shared their facts. I don't know why so many of them have stuck in my mind, but I passed certain classmates and I think, oh, you've never seen snow, or you have all the vowels in the alphabet in your name. And I think it was just fascinating to see what, when given the opportunity to share any one thing about yourself, knowing what you said on that first day and then getting to know you all better as the year went on. Some of them made perfect sense and others I'd like to go back and say, why did you pick that one thing? Because there's so many more facets of you that I think you could have put out there on day one.
First quarter, when everybody took, what was that, Clement?
Uh-huh.
And I don't think everybody did good. It looked like a funeral reception. Something that I've learned from you guys is that you can be from all parts of the world. You can be any ethnic background, and you guys definitely stuck together and created a family.
That you all truly are not that intimidating, and that this is a new process for everyone. And you know, once we really got to know each other, everybody was super friendly.
How hard it is to become a physician assistant and all of the work that's entailed. I'm really impressed with all of the training that you all have before you go out in the field.
The first time I was in the office seeing patients, they had sinks that had regular soap and had hand sanitizer. And I had literally seen the first patient in that office, and I went to clean my hands with the hand sanitizer and it squirted into my eye, and I hopped down the hallway, which became a running joke in that my office mates and my nurse got me a pair of goggles for my birthday that year. They said that was for utilization when I washed my hands. So that was probably my funniest mistake in practice.
Patience. Patience for your patients. I had cancer patients that would scream and yell at me, and I would just kind of nod, and then they would cry and apologize, and I'm like, you know what? I'm not living your life. I don't have to face what you have to face. You give them a little grace, even when they're nasty and rude, and you get a lot in return later when they recognize it. So it's hard, but patience.
Always remembering to put the patient's interests first and remembering that it's gonna be fine. I know I always say that, but it's gonna be fine as long as you do that. So as long as you put the patient's well-being first and do everything you can in the best interest of the patient, you're doing the right thing.
I'm super, super, duper proud of each and every one of you all. You have gone through a lot of changes during this whole process of the program, through thick and thin. Literally, there was a lot of thick parts that was in there, but you guys really stuck it out and to the finish line, and that's why I'm extremely proud of each and every one of you. I look up to y'all now. Love you guys, and continue doing what you're doing, saving lives out here, and making sure everybody's healthy. So love you.
All right, so if I could give one bit of advice to your class, just one thing to always keep in mind that is good for all of life, much less especially for PAs, for interacting with your colleagues, for interacting with patients, is know how to apologize and how to apologize appropriately. Because I can't tell you the number of times I screwed up. I can't tell you the number of times you're gonna screw up. We all do. But having an honest, real apology has three components. You acknowledge it. You don't sit there and make excuses for it. Yep, I did that. You sincerely apologize. I'm sorry. I accept full responsibility for it. And then the final component, what can I do to make it better? I won't ever do it again, but what can I do to make it better? And those three components, acknowledging it, you know, accepting responsibility, and then trying to make it better, and that will just serve you well, especially if you mess up in front of your attending.